Welcome to Up Up Down Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed. And to my other from my sides, we got T Breezy.
Hello there.
We have something to tell you guys.
Unusual episode coming up right here.
What happened is we filmed two episodes and the audio for our voices was not recorded, unfortunately.
We've been plagued with some technology. That's what I said.
You said plagued.
But no, stay on topic. With some technology woes lately.
Tyler Braze.
We recorded some eps with no audio. And then we even recorded a session of Texas Chainsaw where I just froze the whole time. So that was cool.
Yeah.
So technology's been getting us. It's been getting us. But there's always a way to make it work. So this is how we're making it work.
Yes. So what we're going to do is we are going to watch the gameplay back and just chat. So we'll talk about what we're doing, what we're booking, probably kind of. But then just talk, you know.
That's it.
Just a little relaxing chat.
Relaxing, a little podcast with some gameplay. Podcast featuring gameplay.
Yeah. So you'll be able to see what we're doing. And then obviously we'll watch the matches, talk about those. So here we go. We're starting the video.
Week 21. Show 21.
So let's talk about this past weekend.
Let's talk about the weekend, man.
Breezy, you had some shows.
I had a couple shows.
Yeah.
I had a couple shows. They were a lot of fun. I had Prestige Wrestling over in Portland. Very fun crowd. And then I followed up with Wrestling Revolver, which again, very fun crowd. And I must admit, my travel, everything came off how it was supposed to.
Yeah.
But my God, did the travel beat the crap out of me.
Just still exhausted.
Bro.
Yeah.
Like insane. So like, just for an example here, and this takes me back. And I don't know if I have it in me. Like, this is a lot. So I flew out. So my first show was Friday. So I flew out. I had to teach a seminar. So I flew out Thursday morning. I want to say 9 a.m. So that wasn't bad. So I woke up, had breakfast, prepared for the day.
So what time do you wake up when you are flying?
So if I'm leaving at 9:15, that means I had to leave the house at 7 a.m.
Wait.
So I woke up at...
How far is the airport from your house?
About half an hour.
Okay.
And I need to check a bag, and I always give myself half an hour of idiot time where something will happen, you know what I mean? So,
okay.
And then you get there good, you do whatever. So I believe I got up at 6, because make breakfast, last little bit of packing, away you go at 7. So made it there, no delays, everything was good. But it's a 6-hour flight to Seattle. So starting off hot with a 6-hour flight to Seattle, quick hour layover, and then an hour to Portland. So then I got to Portland, got picked up, went right to the seminar, taught the seminar for 2 hours, or 3 hours.
Food?
3 hours.
Food before?
No food. I was already, did I? I think I had food. I think I had yes. I ate in Seattle. My hour layover, I had a nice little meal.
I was gonna say that's a lot.
So I ate then, taught the seminar, went right back to the hotel. at that point, it was so it would have been what like five. Six, it would have been like 9 or 10 on the West Coast time. So then like plus 3 hours for my time. So I'm like going to bed by like 1 or 2 my time.
Which is real late for you.
As real late.
Man. Yeah.
A long day. So then I wake up and the show day, I end up, it was actually pretty chill. I like watched 2 movies.
Okay.
And was just like, all right, like, you know, went to the gym.
What movies?
One called Kandahar with Gerard Butler. It's pretty good.
I like Gerard Butler.
Yeah, pretty good, right? And another one. Can't remember for the life of me. But anyway, end up going to the show. So went to the show that night. I believe the meet and greet was at 4:45. So we started, basically did, sold merchandise, signed autographs, whatever, from 4:45 until about 6:45. And then the show started at 7. So then I was wrestling our good buddy, Matt Cardona, Zack Ryder, whatever you want to call him. So had a match, had a blast, super fun. Ended up just having fun, great little time all around. And then because I had to fly the next morning to Des Moines, I said my goodbyes, talked to the promoter, got back to the hotel, I believe around 10, and slept till 2:30 because then I had to wake up to go to the airport for my flight in the morning, which was at like 4 or 4:30. Flew to Des Moines, so caught a couple hours sleep on the first flight to Denver, and then a couple more hours on the flight to Des Moines. Got there, had a little bite to eat, went to the show, same thing, did a little meet and greet at the beginning, did the meet and greet, did the show, got back a little later to the hotel this time, so this was probably not until like midnight, and then I had to wake up at 2:33 to go to the airport because I had a 5 a.m. flight back to Orlando.
There so we go.
Over the course of 2 days, I got like 6 hours of sleep maybe. Yeah. So like, man, it hit me, dude. I got home and I just like, I was like, no, like I'm so tired. I'm so tired right now. And so yeah, slept like a baby. When I got back on Sunday, slept like a baby last night. I think I was in bed last night by like 9:30. Slept till 9 a.m. this morning.
Just rough. Just rough. Dude.
So as you can see, since after SummerSlam, we're just building. You know how it goes. We build up to a pay-per-view and then we build again. So we got the women's tag titles on fire. My hottest rivalry on here. We got some call-outs going on. Start some rivalries. And then we got the opener with Roman and Truth trying to get that rivalry up and going. Because they're going. They're passing titles back and forth for double champions. But we need a couple more rivalries leading into Mania. So we're getting Eddie and Kane going. We're getting Roddy and Grayson going. And just building some rivalries heading into Mania.
Mm-hmm. You get, because you got to have them. You got to have them.
That's right. You got to have them. They're key.
So that was a very intense travel weekend for you.
That was a welcome back, bud. That was a welcome back weekend.
Hey, here you go. He still got it.
That's right. Yeah. And also you would have laughed your head off the matches that I had. So me and Cardona, very fun. He's on top of the world right now. Yeah. So we had a fun little one, physical, everything else. And then Revolver was just a real different match.
Yeah.
Just to sum it up, we had an entrance off.
Ooh. So
we each had several entrances.
You're talking my language.
You would have loved it. You would have loved everything about this match, by the way. It was myself. It was Dan the Dad.
Oh, yes.
And the Monster Hunter, Matt Palmer.
Perfect.
And so Matt Palmer came out. Dan the Dad came out. I came out. Palmer didn't like that my entrance got the best reaction, so he wanted to do another entrance. So off he went. He comes out to Triple H, big Triple H entrance.
Yeah.
People going crazy. Dan the Dad, like, well.
Wait, they hit Triple H's music?
Oh, yeah. He comes out, spits the water everywhere, chokes on it. It was great.
Oh, here, pause. Fantastic. Don't look at this. Don't look at this real quick. So, ladies and gentlemen, this was my shakeup card that I selected. So you'll see what I pick here. Something that, to me, is very good. I picked the one all the way on the right. I picked that one because I don't want to say because Bree's listening, but this one was for this duration. This one was for this duration. And this last one is for that duration. You can see it. You understand why. So that's something that I feel like will help me in the process of becoming the greatest GM of this season. All right. Yeah, so that sounds like a good solid weekend.
We started with an entrance off, and then we went into I drank a potion and died during the match.
You drank a potion and then died?
Yeah, the potion killed me.
Why did the potion not heal you?
Because it was a bad potion.
So it was a poison.
It was a poison.
So you mean a poison?
Poison potion.
Okay.
Poison potion.
No, just
poison potion.
Just a poison.
No, it was a poison potion.
So
he came out. He had potions with him.
And then, but one was poisoned.
Yes, one was poisoned.
So he sissied you.
A little bit.
Texas Chainsaw Massacre reference, ladies and gentlemen.
There you go.
Sissy can poison the health.
That's right.
Okay.
But so anyway, fun time.
Yeah. So this was over the course of 2 days.
This is over the course of 2 days, yes.
So back home Sunday, you said?
Back home. Yeah, well, yeah, it's because I did the seminar, so I was gone Thursday, Friday, Saturday, home Sunday.
Got you. Okay. Okay, that's a full weekend.
It was a full weekend.
Of bouncing around the country?
The full weekend. Not bad. It was the first weekend of like, hey, man, welcome back. And now next weekend, I have to go to Montana for a show, but just one show, just in and out, so we're good.
Buke?
No, Missoula.
Oh. Ooh, okay. All right.
Yeah. But I wasn't the only one who had a big weekend.
Yeah.
Tell us about your birthday weekend, bud.
You can see it on my face. I'm still not recovered yet. So I go to Dragon Con every year for my birthday. Dragon Con is a huge cosplay event in Atlanta with like four hotels that have a bunch of stuff in them. It's like 60,000 plus people. It's madness. We've been going for, I think this was our 16th year.
Wow. So that's a tradition.
Yeah, it's like me and my best friends. It's like our little family reunion because, you know, like as you get older, you don't have as many chances to go. Not that you don't have as many chances. Life starts moving quickly and you don't see your friends as much sometimes. And so we make sure we set aside that time, Labor Day weekend, to go to this. And then it's just very lucky that it also syncs up with my birthday. But we went and we did a bunch of cosplay. And
what cosplays?
Oh geez, so
I saw a couple of them.
Yeah, Thursday night is the wrestling show, and so my buddy wrestles at that DCW Dragon Con wrestling. It's awesome. Yep. We did Ken and Barbies.
Okay.
So, which there were millions of them at Dragon Con.
Of course.
The entire weekend, all you heard everywhere was "Hi Ken, hi Barbie." On Thursday night, when we get back into the hotel, we're getting our Ken and Barbie stuff, and I walk past this guy who's in this like red and white jacket with a pizza box, and I look at him and I recognize the jacket, I recognize the hat. I'm like, is this guy just his Rip Blazer? And if you don't know who Rip Blazer is, when I worked at G4, Pizza Hut had a sponsorship, and so we made a character that we huh? Case made a character named Rip Blazer, the time traveling pizza delivery man. And
yep.
And this guy has cosplayed that.
And wow.
I lost it. He turned to me and he's like, "Are you Austin Creed?" And I just hugged him.
Yep.
I like, oh, it was so meaningful. Like I told him, I was like, I just went to my hotel room and I cried for 15 minutes.
Yeah.
It was a lot. Was like
Rip Blazer, dude.
Seeing like people cared what we were doing at G4, you know?
People care, man.
It was like very unceremoniously ripped away from us, and it was a really huge part of life at that point in time. And so,
yeah.
Oh no, that was a lot. But anyway, we did Ken, Barbie, and then the next day did candy bars. And I think that I'm about to be done booking this show.
Yeah.
Maybe. It's looking like it. Is he done? He's done. Boom. Okay. We got our opener, Stacey Keibler versus Shayna Baszler. Stacey Keibler, our women's champion. We got McIntyre calling out Nash, big boys, meet. Big tag match. Get this Leviathan and Kane. Oh, yeah, I remember what happened next week. That's funny. And then Six and Finn, the tag champions. We got Giovanni calling out Bad Bunny. We got Dre versus Ray. And we got the dog face Gremlin calling out Booker T. So we throw a little WCW on the show. In the main event, we got a submission match. Bayley and Dana, who's trying to finish that rivalry with this match. Give him a submission. It's level 4, trying to get some fans back. And here we go. We'll do this.
Cosplay.
Do we watch this one? So what, was that a title match? Truth is Champion?
Truth is Champion, US Champion.
Yep, we'll come back to the cosplay stuff.
Starting it off hot.
Let's get through these simulations.
I like it, splitting mm-hmm. up those titles. Splitting mm-hmm. up those titles.
Congrats to our Truth.
One for Roman, one for Truth. Oh, sweet. Great promo, but no rivalry. Mm-hmm. Always good. That's always mm-hmm. great when that happens.
Here we go.
Love when there's no... Oh, a little GM interference.
No rivalry on this one.
There's a rivalry.
Okay.
Three, but no rivalry change, so that's always cool.
Okay.
Love when that happens.
Here we go. Piper. Big fist.
Love when there's no rivalry change at all. Don't know why.
That's my favorite.
Finally, new rivalry. Level one. Orange Julius, Logan Paul.
Going through it right now on social media.
Kane Eddie, rivalry going on.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Is this a spectate?
We're watching this one.
All right, so.
So cosplaying, you did the candy bars?
Yeah, we did candy bars Friday night. And so part of our tradition is the first time we went to DragonCon, we went for this wrestling show, ended up missing it. And so just walking around, we saw everybody in these outfits. We had no clue like what was happening. And then we find out, oh, cosplay, what's cosplay? Somebody explains it to us, they tell us what's going on. And then after walking around for like 2 or 3 hours, we're like, we feel out of place. We gotta rectify this. So what do we do?
Gotta join in.
Yeah, so we go to Walmart to try to find some things to like throw some costumes together. Can't find anything. And so, you know, on the packages of underwear, there's just the underwear model standing there like on a mountain, looking into the distance, wearing little bikini underwear. So we just bought the little bikini underwear and said, screw it, we're underwear models. It's fine.
Yep.
And so every year, with at least one cosplay, it's like very naked. It's just something underwear. That's, like,
yeah, I've noticed it's a theme.
Yeah, it's part of our family tradition.
Was that the bunny one this year?
No, it's evolved into just most of my cosplays are not a lot of clothing.
Sure.
Because that's just how I live my life.
Okay.
So here we go. We did candy bars. So everybody picks a candy bar, and then you just do your interpretation of what that would be as a person.
Okay.
What was the next? Looking. So that was Friday night, and Saturday during the day, we did Willy Wonka. I was the candy man. Nice. We had Oompa Loompas, we had Willy Wonka, we had Veruca Salt. One of our friends is Grandpa Joe, and she looked hilarious. She has a full bald cap and the hair on the back.
Beautiful.
I open up the door and wasn't expecting to see her as an old man, and I was dying.
Yeah.
So that was good. Oh, the sleep process at this thing. Friday, the rave starts at like what? Like 2 or 3, go to the rave for a little bit, and then go eat breakfast at like 5, and then get in the bed at like 6.
I was going to say the sleep process. Do you mean the lack of sleep process?
Yeah. Oh. Get up at like 10:30, come back to my house, get some more cosplay stuff that was getting there that day, come back, put on Willy Wonka. And then midday or like late afternoon, nighttime, we switch to the Winnie the Pooh cosplays. Mm. So that's when I was the rabbit.
That's when you were the rabbit.
But again, your own interpretation. So you go fur coat, obviously, because he's got fur. Some tidy whiteys, but triple up on them because reasons. Some leg warmers, some rabbit feet, rabbit ears, and a bunch of carrots, rabbit nose, pimp cane for no reason.
Yep.
Again, sleep process, hit the rave, breakfast at like 6 that day, in the bed, 7:30, 8, wake up at like 11.
Oh.
Go eat, do a bunch of other stuff, get my hair straightened. And then Sunday night, we did WWE. And so me and Mosley, we did... you're familiar with the Brothers of Destruction.
I've heard of them.
We were the Brothers of Destruction. So just Kane and Undertaker with Tim's on.
Great,
Oh, I didn't even notice this. In this picture of us, there's people making out next to us. Oh, but nice. We know them. Oh, there we go. Oh, that's good for them.
There you go.
Mosley put a grill on Kane's mask.
Oh, nice.
Our friend Ebony was Undertaker, and she had a shaker cup as the urn.
Nice.
It was good. I had a replica of Undertaker's, I believe it's WrestleMania 15. That's when he fought Boss Man, right?
Oh, I'm terrible with that stuff, but probably.
I think it was 15 when he fought Boss Man in the cage. When he hung him from the cell, and then they raised the cell as people were leaving, was one of the most insane things.
It's ridiculous.
I feel like we talk about stuff like Rikishi's bump off the cage, off the cell, into that truck.
Into the truck.
Absolutely insane. We talk about Mankind getting tossed off the cage through the announce table. We don't talk about Boss Man getting hung.
Boss Man getting hung is up there.
Yeah. That should be on more list.
That's a big one. That's a big one up there.
Yeah. So we knocked that out. And then again, the rave till like, this was Sunday. So the rave till like 4 or 5.
Oh my God.
Breakfast at like 7, and then sleep by like 8:30-ish.
Oh.
Up at 11, packed at 11:30, back home by like 12:30, and then it was my birthday on Monday.
Yeah.
And I sat on the couch for a long time.
I was gonna say. Do you remember back in the day, like, pulling an all-nighter was easy?
Oh, yeah.
Now? Impossible. I don't know how you do it.
Bro, with all that water, too?
Oh.
I'm maybe the most hydrated I've ever been.
Wow.
I was like, I need to recharge. This is, Dragon Con is what fills my social cup up for the year. Like,
I believe it.
Yeah.
That's a lot, though.
Because it's hard. Because we're moving around a lot, and you're back in the travel mix now too. So like you said, you left, and now you got to go to the airport. So you got a lot of people that you're dealing with, and then you got a layover. So you got to deal with an extra number of people, and then you get there and you got to meet a new person who's going to give you a ride to a seminar where you're going to meet a ton of new people.
Yeah.
And it's like, I don't know. It gets hard, man.
A lot of peeps, man.
Yeah. And so if I don't,
you know what I'll say though,
what
is the amount of people that I met this weekend that told me how important Uno was to them.
Oh.
Like, the balance is ridiculous. Uno has outweighed my entire career. That's just how it is. But I love it. Signed a bunch of Uno decks.
Yeah.
Uno cards. It's crazy, man.
Dude, it's good, man.
Yeah.
It made
a difference. Peeps loved it.
It's one of those things, too. I feel like we were... Not in a bad way, but like kind of backed into a corner. Like, oh crap, what do we do next? We need something.
Yeah.
And then we started Uno, and it was like, this is.
Well, it's kind of in the same vein as brands, where we literally just did it because we were having fun.
Yeah.
And then people ended up enjoying the fun and being a part of it.
Yeah.
But it's just so funny, man. I laugh every time I hear it, because it's like, oh yeah, you know, it's cool. You were tag champion. It's cool. You were, you know, the only guy to wrestle Liger. But really, the main thing that you did in your entire 15-year career was play Uno with your friends. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that sounds about right. Sounds about right, man.
Dude, when you hit that draw 4, oh.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, man.
But I mean, it's great real. Time. It's real. Great that time. Was
it
fun.
Is. It was great.
Do you know why I wanted us to start playing Uno?
Why?
I played with the New Legacy guys.
Is that how it started?
Yeah, I think I played with John Blood, Danker.
Yep.
And it was hilarious. I was like, oh, we got to play Uno. Yeah. And then it turned into that.
That's right.
Because of them. They've given us so much. Thank you, guys. Is this a count-out finish?
It might be. It ain't moving.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he started moving.
Ooh, that's almost the second today, time getting counted out.
Yep.
Speaking of, did you see Gable versus Gunther last night?
I saw clips of it.
Bro, Gable's the man.
I mean, that's what you'd expect, you know?
It is.
Wow. Ooh. All right.
Kane with a strong finish.
Big Kane, bleeding everywhere. Strong finish.
When was the last time you saw Kane bleed?
Years ago. If ever.
Have you seen Kane bleed?
I don't know, man. He had a mask for a long time.
He did.
And then after that, I'm pretty sure there was no blood.
Did he bleed as Yankum?
Maybe. That was borderline almost before my time.
Yeah?
A little rivalry, Elias and Shelton.
Oh yeah,
we like that.
Yeah, that's
we
great.
Like that.
That's great. Love building a rivalry.
Simulated up, titles on the line, and a rivalry. Simulated, son. Simulated, son.
Come on. Okay, here we go. I tried to watch it.
Steel champs.
Dang.
I was up. 4.5-er. We like that.
That's good. That's a good show.
That's a stale tag rivalry still pulling 4.5s. I really wish there was I feel like that's the next thing in line is there's got to be a way to like pay off a tag rivalry.
Yeah. Yeah.
Cuz they have like a submission match for singles but nothing for tags.
Mm-hmm. And also too, I think there's got to be, and maybe there already is, but we just don't see it cuz we don't see the full algorithm is yeah. the when people earn a singles rivalry, that adding to when they're in a tag match, but them not having to create a tag rivalry. Does that make sense?
Like you mean it makes the tag match better?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you'd think, right?
It probably does already. Don't mind me.
It's possible. We don't know. We don't know the inner workings.
Yeah.
You'd think that we do. We do not.
I would like for it to, like, let's say I have two singles rivalries, and then yeah. I put them in a tag match, babies against heels.
Yep.
Rather than starting a tag rivalry, it increases their singles rivalries. You know, so then I can still have more options. But maybe it does do that and we just suck at this.
You never know. You know what also could be interesting?
What?
If you had two singles rivalries, instead of putting them against each other, what if you teamed them up on the same team? So you had like a babyface and a heel against a babyface and a heel.
I would love that.
Would that work?
I don't think in this version.
No? I don't think we've ever tried.
We probably have, but just forgot.
Me.
If I'm being honest. If we played consistently instead of in chunks, we would be way better at this game.
I don't know.
I do. Because if I'm being honest, this is my favorite thing about these games, right?
Yep.
I love playing, like actually playing the game. I love the creator wrestler. It's awesome. Yep. But the GM stuff.
GM is, stuff.
I would pay the money that this game costs for just a extremely flushed out version of the GM mode.
Yeah. Yeah.
And with what they had last year, plus what they have this year, we're like on our way.
Yeah. 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 Well, they definitely made improvements.
Oh, huge ones. And then even
huge improvements from 22 to 23.
Yeah. And then even when they dropped the updates, when it's like, oh, we need like belts or these tag things or these, like, and they put them in there and they listen. So I don't know. I very much trust this crew. Jeez, with the stuff they've been doing.
Oh, yeah.
The GM mode.
I'm very curious for 24 to see what
they're
because I know that they're going to improve on it.
Yeah.
You know they are.
Yeah. I'm impatient. I can't wait for it in 25 because I know next year is going to be really good, but I know that the following one's going to be even better because like we said, they laid all the groundwork and like the foundation of the house is so solid now. Like once they hit the reset button and started everything over, and I was like, oh, the concrete has been laid, the steel beams are in there, and this is level one of the house.
That's right.
Foundation was last year. We've got level one. We got a nice ranch right now. Next year, second story is getting put on.
Yep.
They've been adding furnishings. We got a nice backyard. We got pinwheels in the front, gnomes, wind chimes. It's looking good.
I like it.
Spent the yesterday, Monday.
Yep.
Recuperating.
Are you fully recouped?
No. And I'm still nursing my cervical strain that I'm dealing with from last week from Drew McIntyre throwing that chair at me.
Ah, yes.
You know?
Yes. The old chair to the face.
Yeah, that's why I wasn't at Raw yesterday.
Yep.
Which somebody said that was him getting payback for me not putting him in that main event on the show.
Ah, I love that. I love after you promised him the main event. That was his payback. Life imitating art, man. I like it.
Dude.
That's great.
That's like, all right.
That's actually really cool.
I don't know if I want that or I want you to hold me up for 100K, dude. It's...
Yeah, I mean, either one. I like it, though.
Yeah. Mm. So, okay, so you're back in the mix, traveling, doing shows. You're fully back in the mix. Like, you're going to be bumping every weekend?
Just about, yeah. I got Montana next weekend. I have one. The weekend after that is off. Mm-hmm. But then the weekend after that, I got a signing in L.A. and then also a show in L.A. And then the weekend after that, I have a show in Omaha, Nebraska. Mm-hmm. Then the weekend after that, I have a show in Tennessee. And I believe that's all I'm booked up for so far.
Dang.
But there's more coming up.
Feeling that calendar.
Whoa! That was a little decisive.
Yes, she ran through her.
Legend.
She's an escapes. New champion. Proud of her.
Level 3, 4 star.
Look at that.
Solid rivalry build.
And that's 2 weeks, what? 2 weeks before Mania, or we got what?
3.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, this is show 21 right here.
It's just so funny because we've booked the next two things. So yeah, I'm like, yeah. Oh, yeah, this did happen.
That's right. That's right.
Guys, just so you know, we've booked Mania. We have not watched it yet.
We booked Mania. Fully booked.
Oh. Drew and Nash.
A little new rivalry.
Lots of things happened between now and then.
Lots of things happened. Lots of things. The coming weeks. Will be very telling.
So hold on to your butts.
Yeah.
I tried to spectate this. You can't spectate this?
Nah. Nah, okay.
Let's see.
Ooh.
2.5.
Well, 2.5-er.
Rough. That one hurts. I'm going to start doing that 6 pose.
You don't already?
No.
That's a wide, wide one.
Yeah.
Real bad call-out promo right there. No rivalry and weak.
Oh yeah, because we saw. So what happened here is Giovanni's got the 2 on the mic, and I think Bad Bunny has a 5.
Yeah.
Dre just putting it down. Right where we go 3
4 and rivalry up.
This is a hell of a show, I'm gonna admit.
This is a pretty good show.
Yeah.
Weak tag match in there, but
it's fine.
Not a bad show. Not a bad show.
Do we figure that out? I don't know. We'll have to keep watching.
That's right.
Rivalry grows.
Man, rivalry's growing.
3 to 4.
All your rivalry's going up.
Just really putting in the work as a general manager the weeks coming into Mania, because we know that's where we're going to make a lot of money. It's like Black Friday for all the people in sales that understand the lingo, you know?
Yeah.
We're gearing up.
So Mish with a run-in.
Okay.
Trying to start that new rivalry or what?
No, we have a rivalry, Bayley and Dana. But Gigi is the tag partner to Bayley with a pretty high popularity. So he said, come on, let's go ahead and do it. Solid all around.
Solid all around.
Solid.
Competitive, solid shows.
We're checking. We're checking
couple,
here.
Couple rivalries going up. Just checking the rivalries. No injuries. We've actually been pretty solid with injuries, man.
We have, but I feel like we've been... cautiously cautious.
We've been careful. We've been careful. So people have creeped down there. They just haven't got injured.
Yeah. See, because I get nervous when my people get into like the 60s.
Yeah.
I feel like you let them get into like the 30s.
30s is that sweet spot, but you're playing with fire a little bit.
Yeah. I can't. Especially because then I'll see somebody in the 60s like in week 1 of the month.
Yeah.
Knowing I got 3 more weeks to go. I'm like, ah. Maybe a tables match. Maybe you rest.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
52,000.
Mm-hmm.
Give me that mon, that big stadium.
Mm-hmm.
2,138.
Looking good.
Yeah.
Leviathan and Kane work together.
Well.
Yeah. Ooh, nice. But see, this is the thing. It says they're saying that their beef isn't settled. Dana and Bayley, but I did the submission
they
match.
They want to keep going. They want to keep going.
No, they said they want it to finish because it's week 4, it's stale, but yeah. I put in the submission to finish it, but we're wondering if the GG run-in squashed the submission.
I think
it
did.
The rivalry.
I must finishing. Have.
Yeah.
Also, Bayley's tweet right there.
Yeah.
Very on brand.
Very.
I love it. That's great.
Oop.
Well, at this point, these cards have been played, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's fair. Look at how close it is.
Wow.
Look at how close it is, dude.
Woo-wee!
All right.
Less than 50,000.
Yeah. And so we have another one of these episodes, just one more like this, coming up next week. Freeze in first place. You getting something delivered?
No. There must be somebody walking outside.
Hey.
Got my little guard pup, dude.
Hey.
Got that guard pup.
All right, Breeze, I'm gonna let you close it out.
Me close it out?
Yeah, you go ahead.
All right, as you can see, still numero uno. Thank you guys for joining. Road to WrestleMania. Week 22 coming up next week. Click the buttons. Subscribe, like, share, everything. And until then, always and forever, keep it.